Hi, I'm Phoebe Legere, and welcome to Roulette TV. Tonight our guest is composer Ikoue Mori. Ms. Mori was the drummer for the seminal rock band DNA. In recent years, she has brilliantly redefined the art of drumming. Her CD, 100 Aspects of the Moon, won the Prix Ars Electronica Distinctive Award in 1999. She has many CDs, and her collaborators are some of the most distinguished names in new music: John Zorn, Derek Bailey, Kim Gordon, and Fred Frith. Everything Ikoue does and everything she touches is magical, mysterious, and original. Roulette TV is honored to present composer Ikoue Mori. Thank you. So you must tell us about the process through which you came to be probably the most expressive and creative drum machine artist of all time. What happened to you?
From drop set to a drum machine actually took like 10 years, you know? Like, the DNA was actually not improvised at all. We were jamming to make songs, and then, but on the stage, you never improvised. It's all like set and playing same song, same set over and over and over for 5 years. Then, after DNA broke up, I was looking for next things to do. Then I met John Zorn and also improviser, then working in downtown.
How is it different, I mean, for you as a musician? What is the experience of playing in a rock band, playing the same song over and over again for 5 years? How does that feel different in your heart or in your spirit than improvising?
Well, but then you have have to know this rock band, but still the DNA is like, it's not, for me now think about DNA, it's like playing music, it's more like doing a ritual almost. So it's like it goes through this ritual through, you know. So not feel like playing rock music over and over. It's a little different from that.
You've made some great records. I really love your records.
Thank you.
This record, 100 Phases of the Moon, is that the name of it?
Aspects.
100 Aspects of the Moon seems to all have been scored. So you reintroduced structure somehow into your music. Can you talk about the structures that you use in creating this music?
Well, structure is from this book of ukiyo-e, the Yoshitoshi's book called 100 Aspects of the Moon. So the each 100 of story of about the moon, and then so this picture, the ukiyo-e, the visual made me this inspiration about music. It really kind of direct for me, direct impact this ukiyo-e did. And then that's, there's a story behind all the story, I mean a story behind this illustration, and then just, I don't know, it's very easy to come to me as a one story or different kind of structures within songs.
I noticed that you had a piano motif that came in and became transformed. It was almost like some kind of a theme.
Tonight?
Yes.
Yes.
Can you talk about the structure of this piece? What's it called?
Ventriloquist in Ghost Chamber.
Ventriloquist in Ghost Chamber.
Yeah. Well, this was give me idea when I was in the museum running to this painting of Paul Klee. The title is Ventriloquist, and then this picture of a little beast inside of a transparent stomach, human stomach, and talking each other. So
really?
That's gave me the idea, this piece, and then also the way I played, make music, and then DJ Olive make sounds like unconventional instruments to make sounds, that kind of I thought be a good title for it.
How did you choose these two players that tonight?
Because Gregor, the DJ Oli, because of this somebody that unconventional instruments player I wanted to use, and then Kato, the way he plays bass is so different from
very, very nice. It's a great band.
Yes, they do this magic into this my piece I knew.
How do you think your life would have been different if you had stayed in Tokyo?
Completely different.
Do you ever think about that?
Yeah, because I think my life really start liberated when I moved to New York. Because I wasn't a musician, I was a student, but I wasn't really think of I can be a musician in Japan, because always the man around me is a musician, and or the girlfriend was supporting boyfriend, and here just everybody just picking up, and I met so many powerful women in here, and then they really inspire me and liberate me.